Actually, we worked on this use case, the two of us, but my colleague couldn't make it today. So our project is called the Public Health Gateway, which is aimed at, you know, reducing motorcycle accidents in Kenya, which is actually becoming a menace. Okay, so we did our research and we visited one of the provincial hospitals in Kenya, that is Nakuru Provincial Hospital. And out of the 80 capacity ward that is available in the hospital, it's predominantly occupied by motorcycle accidents. And 90% of these victims are actually men, of which half of them are aged between 19 to 35. So from that figure, you can see that our youth are actually dying, the biggest victims of motorcycle accidents. Out of all the motorcycle accidents, we figured out that 40% actually succumb to these accidents. This can be attributed to the increased number of motorcycles in the country since the government abolished the importation tax for motorcycles. So there was an influx in the number of motorcycles, and then the infrastructure didn't quite increase. So there was like a competition of the same road space, which obviously lead to congestion and accidents. So we established that although, you know, there was an increase, but yes, there are some really well-known black spots, road black spots, which are not publicly known, but the officials, the policemen and the doctors are aware of these locations. However, the public, that is the motorcycle riders and the general public, are not aware because there's no mechanism of, you know, distributing that information to them. So we decided, why not come up with a solution to, you know, distribute this information to these guys who are riding. So that's when we came with the Public Health Gateway. So our solution has two major parts. There's a mobile application and there's a web platform. The web platform is used to record the motorcycle accidents, while the mobile application is like it delivers the information to the public. So the mobile application is free, although it's not yet on the Google Play Store. But for you to access the web platform, you have to be authenticated. And we use federated authentication for us to know who you are so that you can be able to record such cases. So our use case is the only people who are able to record the accidents, ideally, is supposed to be the doctors and the policemen, because they are the first respondents to accidents. And they are the ones that get the raw data of such accidents. So these are the guys that we are looking at, you know, recording the accidents. And once the accident is recorded on the web platform, it is broadcasted instantly to all the connected devices. So as soon as I record an accident on the web platform, you are able to get a notification immediately on your phone if you are within a radius. We're using a 1 kilometer radius. So if you are within a 1 kilometer radius, you'll get a notification that there's been an accident recorded at such and such place. It will give you the exact location and you can actually see it on your map. Once you launch the application, you are able to see a map that has marked out positions. So in Catania, some of the tools, we chose to use two tools to build our use case. That is GLibrary for access of the data and Future Gateway that is used for processing the data in the backend. So once the data is recorded, our gateway processes it and gives, you know, output in terms of the severity of accidents and where the accidents have been recorded. And then from that information, we are able to relay the same information to mobile applications. So once you launch your mobile application, depending on where you are and depending on the number of previously recorded accidents, you're able to know whether you're in a dangerous region or you're in a safe region. Okay. So that is how the accident recording form looks like. As you can see, we collect all that information, which is obviously we use in determining the severity of the accident. So you can see there's the road surface, the weather, whether it was rainy, whether it was sunny, and the severity of the accident, and all that information that you see. So all that goes in the backend and it's processed to, you know, generate results. And those results are the ones that, you know, we feed to the general public. And the data is available on a live basis. So once you are logged in into the web portal, this is what you see. And from this map, you can just click anywhere where the accident has actually occurred and record it on that specific location. You don't need to enter coordinates because, the map already will pick your coordinates of wherever you'll click. You can also search. There's a search bar on the top top left corner. You can search the place, and once you locate it, you click on it and you add an accident. Now that is a result of the processing. As you can see, there are some red regions and some other regions that are not marked. The regions that are marked with red, that red is a representation of the number of accidents that have occurred. So anyone within a 1 kilometer radius, anywhere in that red marked area, you'll always get voice notification that, you know, you're in a dangerous region and you should probably do this and this. We're giving you, the application will give you voice information regarding on road safety, practices, how you should ride, whether you should keep left or keep right. And so that's the interface of the application. It's just a very simple interface because you don't want to distract you when you're on the road. And it actually runs in the background. You don't need to, you know, to be on this screen. You can just exit the screen and it will run in the background. So the purpose of it running in the background is that we are able to give you live information via voice commands, because you don't want to get textual, because it's a distraction. So it will give you voice information from the background, and what if maybe you're stuck in traffic and you want to see the surroundings of your area. Once you launch the application, that's what you see. You will see either of the three colors depending on where you are. The first one is a safe zone, which basically means no accidents have been recorded. Then a medium accident zone, which is marked by yellow color, and the most dangerous place is marked with red. We naturally identify red with danger, so we chose to use red. Yes, that is a poster representing a whole use case in one picture. As you can see on the top row, there is the recording through a web interface. Then there's our science gateway is there, and then there's a analysis that takes place there. After the analysis, the data is fed directly to all the listening mobile devices, and then from that, the result is we have reduced road accidents and safety in our roads. Okay, our future plans are to partner with emergency services, and these are fire brigade, ambulances, such that if there's any reported incidents, we don't need to wait for maybe a doctor or a policeman to come and record that. That data is sent directly to the gateway, and then later on, once all the relevant information has been collected, we can now go and edit and try and get the correct information regarding that specific accident. And we are also planning to launch it officially and run tests on the real data, because currently we've just been using test data. We want to run it on the real ground and get the real data and the real experience of the use case. And at the end of the day, we also want to generate reports where we can give the local authorities, and they can use it to make policies, like maybe add some road bumps or whatever they decide. But we want to generate reports of, depending on the area, whether this is a very accident prone region or what the road state is bad, probably something like that, and then give that to the authorities. Yeah, so thank you for listening, and that's our use case.